Welcome back to the channel. Today we'll be taking a look at 7 classic motorcycles begging for a comeback. Number 7. Norton F1 Sport. The Norton F1 Sport was a motorcycle that dared to be different. Forget the usual 4-stroke engine thump. This 1990s machine pulsed with the smooth power of a Wankel rotary engine, a technology that promised a lighter, smoother ride. Wrapped in sleek fiberglass fairing, the F1 Sport wasn't just powerful, it was a head-turner. But don't be fooled by its good looks. This wasn't a relaxed cruiser. The F1 Sport was a beast waiting to be unleashed, demanding a skilled rider at the helm. With only 70 ever produced, the F1 Sport is a true collector's item. Its 588cc twin-rotor engine might not churn out the highest horsepower by today's standards, but back in its day, it was a force to be reckoned with. So why aren't we seeing more Nortons with Wankel engines zooming down the highway today? Complexity and emissions regulations played a part in the demise of this intriguing technology. But for those who crave a unique riding experience and a piece of motorcycling history, the Norton F1 Sport remains an object of fascination. Perhaps with advancements in technology, the rotary engine will see a comeback, and the F1 Sport's spirit will live on in a new generation of motorcycles. Number 6. Honda VTR 1000. The Honda VTR 1000, also known as the Firestorm or Superhawk depending on where you wink at, wasn't your typical cookie-cutter sport bike. Produced from 1997 to 2005, this motorcycle dared to be different. Forget the in-your-face, aggressive look. The VTR 1000 sported a clean, understated design that hinted at its potential without screaming it. It was a sleeper agent in the world of motorcycles. Underneath that cool exterior lurked a throaty 996cc, 90-degree V-twin engine. This wasn't a dainty engine by any means. It packed a punch with a respectable 110 horsepower and loads of torque, making it a joy to ride on twisty roads. Honda wasn't afraid to break the mold with the VTR 1000. It boasted innovative features like a single-cast engine case and the largest carburetors ever seen on a production motorcycle at the time. These advancements made the VTR 1000 a truly unique motorcycle experience. Sadly, the VTR 1000 didn't see the light of day forever. Honda discontinued it in 2005. There's a murmur of longing among some riders for a comeback. The combination of comfort, power, and distinctive style makes the VTR 1000 a motorcycle that left its mark, and a return would surely be welcomed by those who crave a sporty ride with a touch of personality. Number 5. Aprilia Dorsoduro 750. The Aprilia Dorsoduro 750 wasn't a bulky touring bike built for comfort cruising, and it wasn't a speed demon hellbent on torching the racetrack. Instead, it carved out its own niche, a street-legal supermotard with a playful personality. Standing tall with tall suspension and knobby tires, it looked ready to tackle anything you threw at it, from city streets to light off-road trails. Power came from a 750cc V-twin engine that punched out a respectable 92 horsepower. It wasn't a fire-breathing monster, but it offered enough grunt to put a smile on your face without leaving you white-knuckled. However, the Dorsoduro wasn't without its quirks. The tall, wide handlebars took some getting used to, and the seat height might leave shorter riders feeling a bit tippy-toed. Fuel efficiency wasn't exactly its strong suit either, thanks to the thirsty V-twin engine. Sadly, Aprilia discontinued the Dorsoduro 750 in 2016. But for those who crave a motorcycle that's as comfortable on the dirt as it is on the asphalt, the Dorsoduro remains a legend. With a little modern tweaking, perhaps this Italian supermotard could make a glorious return someday. Number 4. Bimota SB6-R. The Bimota SB6-R is an Italian stallion that boasts a single-seat design that screams exclusivity, leaving your pillion passenger stranded on the sidewalk. But fear not, this solo ride is all about the rider-machine connection. The sleek bodywork flows seamlessly into the underseat exhaust, creating a silhouette that's both audacious and aerodynamic. Powering this beast is a Suzuki-derived 1100cc engine, a proven performer that injects a thrilling surge of acceleration. With 156 horsepower on tap, the SB6-R isn't shy about unleashing its muscle. However, this motorbike is more than just brute force. Bimota equipped it with top-shelf components like Pioli forks, an Ohlins shock, and Brembo brakes, ensuring a ride that's as sharp as it is swift. So why isn't the SB6-R a household name? It boils down to a hefty price tag and somewhat limited production run. But for a discerning rider who craves a unique blend of Italian flair and Japanese muscle, the SB6-R remains an unforgettable icon. Perhaps a modern comeback is in order, with a dash of updated technology to perfectly complement its timeless design and thrilling performance. Number 3. Honda CB750. The Honda CB750 isn't just a motorcycle, it's a history lesson on two wheels. Debuting in 1969, this machine was a game changer. Forget clunky British bikes, the CB750 was sleek, boasting a revolutionary four-cylinder engine that put out a respectable 67 horsepower. That might not sound like much today, but back then, it was enough to turn heads and leave rivals in the dust. Imagine cruising down a Californian highway in the 70s, the wind whipping through your hair as the CB750 effortlessly eats up the miles. Its air-cooled design and comfortable, upright riding position made it a joy to ride, and its reliability meant you could trust it to get you there without a fuss. Fast forward a few decades, and the CB750's legacy lives on. It's a favorite among enthusiasts who appreciate its classic good looks and timeless engineering. Sure, there are faster, flashier machines out there, but the CB750 offers a sense of connection to motorcycling's golden age. Here's the thing though, with the rise of high-performance machines, the CB750 feels like a forgotten relic. But maybe, just maybe, it's time for a comeback. In a world obsessed with horsepower and features, the CB750 offers a refreshing alternative, a reminder that motorcycling is about the journey, not just the destination. So Honda, are you listening? The world might just be ready for a dose of CB750 cool again. Number 2. Ducati 748. The Ducati 748, a motorcycle that roared onto the scene in the mid-1990s, still turns heads today. This Italian stallion boasts the kind of curves that would make a supermodel jealous. Designed by Massimo Tamburini, the 748 is a close cousin of the Ducati 916, sharing its stunning silhouette and trellis frame. Nestled within its sleek fairings is a 748cc Desmodromic L-twin engine. Now that might sound fancy, but it basically means this bike is a thrill-seeker's dream. It might not be the most powerful beast on the road, offering around 98 horsepower depending on the model year, but what it lacks in muscle it makes up for in agility. This lighter engine, compared to its bigger siblings, makes the 748 a sharper handler, especially loved by those who crave a responsive ride. However, like many a gorgeous Italian sports car, the 748 is high maintenance. Owning one is a commitment, and parts can be pricey. Finding a good mechanic who speaks fluent Ducati is also key. But for riders who appreciate a motorcycle that's equal parts beauty and brawn, the 748 is a legend that deserves a comeback. With its timeless design and exhilarating performance, this Ducati is a reminder that sometimes, less is truly more. Number 1. Yamaha V-Max. Forget the laid-back, chrome-laden touring machines. This motorcycle leans forward, a muscular stance that hints at the thrill ride that awaits. Its broad body and squat design exude an aggressive confidence, a look that's been turning heads since 1985. Peek under the sculpted fuel tank, and you'll find a monster of an engine. The 1679cc, liquid-cooled V4 engine isn't messing around. It packs a serious punch, with 200 horsepower waiting to be unleashed. Twist the throttle and hold on tight. The V-Max rockets forward with an exhilarating burst of acceleration that'll leave you breathless. It's a brutal reminder that this machine is built for speed, not leisurely Sunday cruises. Sadly, Yamaha discontinued the V-Max in 2020. But for those who crave a motorcycle that blends head-turning style with heart-pounding power, the V-Max remains a legend. It's a motorcycle that carves its own path, a true beast on two wheels. Perhaps one day Yamaha will heed the calls of V-Max enthusiasts and bring this iconic machine back for another round. Until then, pre-owned V-Maxes are a testament to the enduring legacy of this unforgettable motorcycle. And with this, we have reached the end of this video. If you found it helpful, then make sure to like it, and subscribe to the channel for future upcoming videos.